Now, choucroute. Tell us about the process of it being made.
Choucroute. My grandpa used to do that, actually. Big cabbage, white cabbage.
Yeah.
Used to have a fantastic, like a grater, but yeah. Big one, on a board. Grate the cabbage,
yeah.
Really thin, direct into a small wooden barrel.
Yeah.
You put some salt, you put some bay leaf, you yeah. put some white wine. And when it's filled up, you put weight on it
yeah.
and put it in a dark in your cellar. And they go and marinate. And just
who the hell would have thought putting cabbage in an oak barrel, leaving it and just leaving it in a cellar, and you end up with choucroute?
And that's it, exactly.
Okay,
yes,
so we're gonna cook so this. Okay, so
shallots.
Yeah.
Okay, put the pan on. We're going to sweat some of the shallots, and the choucroute's been rinsed because when it's out of the barrel,
yeah.
you need to rinse it and yeah. press it so you get rid of all the acidity and everything.
Now this sausage intrigues me because most smoked sausages are actually cooked, you know, but this one's not cooked.
No, we're going to cook it. With the sauerkraut, so it will give yeah. the whole flavour. Cook about for 20, 22 minutes.
Right. I mean, is it often the case that you cook it, particularly in wine and or a little bit of stock?
Oh, stock, yeah, but lager is very good.
Lager?
Lager is better.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, it gives this kind of a touch of a sweet flavour.
It is great stuff, sauerkraut. I don't understand why people don't use more of it back home in the UK.
I really love that. Some pepper in here.
I'll get you some garlic. You
little bit. Couple of garlic. That's it. Sausage. First of all, pick a bit of sausage there.
And if people can't get this sort of smoked sausage and stuff, what would they go for at home?
Maybe like some smoked pancetta, chorizo. Yeah. Very good yeah. because it does go well with the cod.
There you go.
Put that in here like this. Almost cover.
That's just chicken stock you're going to put on there?
Yeah, I just put the chicken stock on that one. You can use a, I don't know if you can use
lid on.
Lid on.
Cook that for how long?
We cook that for about 20 minutes. 25 sausages will be cooked.
Fantastic.
Spread the flavour. Use a bit of the bouillon later on.
20 minutes. Which gives me just time to show you a technique which might come in handy later. Now this is one of the first things that I learned when I was cooking. Segmenting a grapefruit or an orange. It's actually really simple, but there's a technique behind it to get the most amount of fruit and segments out. Now what you do is just top and tail it like that, and then ideally follow the shape of the fruit itself. So you're cutting round until it's all removed. Now what I do is take that white part there and use that as a little guide, so when you cut round, you'll end up with most of the flesh still on the fruit, and hardly any on the skin here. Now this is a grapefruit, the same applies when you're doing an orange, lime, lemon, anything like that. I mean, quite simply, just knife down one side, knife down the other side, and then the segment just pulls out. So following again, down one side, then you cut down the other side, nice and tight, because you want all the flesh still on the segment. Then follow the other side, and the segment just falls out. It's as easy as that. And that's how to segment a grapefruit. You've got to see inside this pot. Look at that. The smell is unbelievable.
I know, it's fantastic. Look at that.
And the sausage is cooked?
Yeah. We're going to rest it.
Oh, I'll tell you what. A
couple of minutes, we're going Brilliant. To cook the fish.
So I'll leave that to one side. Fabulous. And then we're going to cook the fish now.
Yep.
Now, this is a perfect sort of match, isn't it, really? The sausage and the cod.
It goes very well with cod, like it would be very good as well with monkfish.
Right, okay.
But personally, I prefer that.
You prefer the cod. These are often, you know, often Fantastic. In the at home, in the supermarkets. We don't often see these anymore. This is a nice little darn, isn't
it? No, yeah. It's quite nice in Dan. I think the flavour is a touch different.
Basically, this is a whole fish or a whole cod, just cut straight through the middle, so you've got That's the bone correct, in it as well.
Yeah.
But the bone helps it keep moist as well, doesn't it? It holds it together.
Yes, it does.
Yeah. So you're cooking it in half butter, half olive oil.
Yeah.
Cod especially doesn't take very long at all, does it, really? Just once.
No, it doesn't.
Literally.
Really.
A couple of minutes each side.
Smell it.
There's just something magic about just simple ingredients, isn't there? Just cut nice and simply.
But because I think the advantage we've got, like today, we buy it's extremely fresh. You don't need really much to complicate. It's just, and you can straight away see it on the colour and on the smell when you cook.
And that's one of the fundamental things by doing this series that I've taken back, is literally seasonality. You have to do so little to it when it comes to cooking.
Absolutely. And that's why, actually, there's a lot of, nowadays, obviously, restaurants which do so-called modern cooking, really complicated, with a lot of different, you know, stuff. Yeah. But I think, like, we're doing there, I think it's the produce are talking for themselves.
Yeah, exactly.
I think it's really the difference.
Yeah.
Definitely. Yeah. Look at that.
So it's almost cooked right the way through, isn't it, really?
Yes, almost. Yeah. Half a minute, then it's fantastic.
I'm going to attempt to do something. Chopped parsley in windy circumstances doesn't really work because it normally goes all over the place. But just lightly chopped parsley, yeah?
Yeah, just lightly. We're just going to put some on the top. You manage it. Didn't took off.
It's not blowing everywhere. There you go.
Okay.
There you go. There you go.
Okay, now I'm going to wipe this, slow down the thing a little bit.
So a simple little sauce to go with this?
Yeah, just little bit of the bouillon we used earlier.
Bit of the cream. Parsley goes in.
Parsley goes in.
I'll turn the heat off now because that's going to
turn the heat.
End up with nothing.
Like this. Up. Bit of seasoning.
Salt. Now, and then you can do your thing with this. This is.
Et voilà.
I'm interested in seeing this and tasting it.
And tasting it.
There you go. This is very, very French.
It is very French.
Very French.
But it is also really, really nice. The side there.
Some sauce.
Sauce. Spoon.
And cloth.
Cross as well, so I don't burn myself.
Love it how he does that little.
I know, you always tell me that. Here we go.
Looks good.
Today we've got pan-fried cod on a bed of sauerkraut, smoked sausage, and a light creamy sauce with herb.
It'd be rude not to sort of...
Yes, I know, you too.
Should we dive in?
Come on, let's go.
Dive in. There you go. Let's have a taste of this.
Look at the flake, the colour.
Fish looks brilliant, doesn't it?
And you need to take the sausage, come on.
So, yeah, take a little bit of sausage.
Absolutely, a little bit, yes. I'm happy with that.
You're happy with that?
Yeah.
That is great, isn't it?
Definitely.
Just how Mama used to make?
Almost.
The man's a genius.